And then there is something superstitious or something naturalistic. This I'm not really sure. And that is the new moon sitting in the arm of the old moon. This is something like that. Okay. This is eclipse, moon, lunar eclipse. 可是我们有分月全食，那就不，我英文不知道怎么讲。这个是，这不是月全食，偏食。Anyways, this is a kind of eclipse, which is said to be an evil omen, in traditional society. But it is said that some scientists even confirm that because of the moon has to do with Earth's gravitation. So when there is something happening to the moon, then it's possible that there will be sea changes or storms, weather changes too. Okay, so this omen is not completely superstitious, but it does take an important space in this point. Okay, and also in the rhyme of the ancient mariner. Okay, and finally, we have talked about the contrast between Sir Patrick Spence and the nobles and the ladies. The nobles follow him on the ship, although they are not, they are reluctant. They follow him, okay. But the ladies are waiting. So they the two groups of people, they take different positions, but basically they are not willing. They want to be in a comfortable position. Okay, the ladies cannot get it because they don't get their man back, and the nobles will not get it because they'll die. No, they'll have to not only wear their heels but the whole thing, the whole body. Okay, they'll be drowned, in other words. Okay. Oh, the other thing which can be discussed further is the word play. Before the play, this is line 31. Long before the play were played. Okay, so the play is that just a theater, a theatrical play in a court or a game that suggesting that the court is being just playful, doing a trick to play with the lives of the people the king sent to the sea. So the word play can be further discussed too. Okay, so all of this suggests that although the ballad is apparently simple, if you sing it, maybe you don't feel that there are some rich meanings implied, but they can really be examined and then further discussed. Definitely, the idea of loyalty. I don't think the people today will be as loyal to a king or a despot. 暴君, as people were in the past. In the past, we have the saying like "君命不可违," etc., etc. But nowadays, we don't completely agree with that. But basically, the other element which is worth considering is weather. I guess although there is a large temporal gap between the poem, the ballad Sir Patrick Spence and us. We can still say that there is something we can relate to, and that is the uncertainty we face because of the climate changes. That sometimes when you go on a plane, you are pretty much in the air. I always feel that, whenever like my relatives or me myself go on the plane, I just feel that I'm in the air. I'm never sure, whether I'll be able to land safely. So I'll be very happy whenever I get to land, and then find myself safe. Okay, so I think this is something related to accidents and disasters which people face in the past, and we do also in the present time. But at the end, there is this tribute paid to the hero. Okay, that this hero, he is aware of the irony of his life, but he follows the order. And at the end, he lies deep in the sea with his lord at his feet. So at the beginning, we have the knight at the knee of the king, you know, being flattering, being obedient, giving some nasty suggestions. At the end, we have the loyal lords following Sir Patrick Spence, and they all die, and the lords are at his feet. And Sir Patrick Spence still keep this heroic position of having his subordinate as subordinates at his feet. Of course, you can say that this is impossible. They will be just bones, a heap of bones. Okay, but I think the song or the ballad presented this way to honor Sir Patrick Spence, to see him as a hero even after death. Yeah. Okay. Yes, I think we're done with that. Just finally, another poem, classic Chinese poem, which is similar to this ballad. Okay, again, you know, two elements. Like Sir Patrick Spence is more complicated. This is more like a lyric. 就像是刚刚那个 Western Wind. Western Wind, we have weather, the concern with weather, and then the need of love, the need of comfort. And here, there is this opposition between Gong and He. One individual, one hero, and the river. Okay, 公敬渡河，堕河而死，江奈公河。So at the end, 江奈公河, you know, still honors Gong. You know, the speaker seems to suggest that you really shouldn't have done this, but you are heroic in doing that. And then at the end, I can do nothing about you. 江奈公河, you know, so Gong is still respected for his heroic decision. Okay, so I think that basically in this semester there are two central themes we are dealing with. One is love, and the other is human boundaries. You know, how some characters, some heroes, try to break down the boundaries, try to cross them, but then, you know, sometimes the consequences can be different. Yeah, so these are the two major themes we're dealing with. Okay, let's take a break, and after the break, we'll move on to Barbara Allen. Just now, I play you one version of Barbara Allen. A kind of melodious modern version of Barbara Allen. Okay, and there are... there are four versions at Insight. Let me show you where you can find them. Here, there is Barbara Allen 1 and 2, right? Text and reference here, and you click on 多媒体教学, and here you get two versions. And you'll find that some traditional versions are really not melodious.
But none the better you'll never be, for you won't get Barbara Allen. Don't you remember last Friday night when we were out of dwelling, drinking wine with the ladies round and slighted Barbara Allen? He turned his pale face to the wall, she turned her back upon him.
The most commonly repeated theme or part of the story is that the guy neglected Barbara Allen at the tavern. Okay, but sometimes there'll be changes of the names. Like here, it's called Bobby Allen. The guy's name can also have different names, like John, William, different names. And sometimes it's called Barbara Allen. So very soon I'm going to show you the three, four versions that I include in the handout. So just don't forget where you can get the different versions. I think I like, probably because I grew up with the bands like Peter, Paul and Mary, Simon and Garfunkel. Paul Simon is, I think, still famous. He has an album called Rhythm of the Blue. And he has also another album made with another African band, and he had kind of a movement for South Africa, which got him very popular, really well liked, well respected. Towards the end of the apartheid, 就是加南非种族隔离 towards the end of the, that period. Okay, so this is Garfunkel's version, and then there's another version here.
The Christmas stabbing and the year when the green leaves were fallen.
Okay, and at the end of the PowerPoint, you get a link of the ballad of Barbara Allen. And when you follow this link, you get this one.
"'Twas in the merry month of May,
let me see,
when green buds all were swelling, sweet William
Moore." I don't know the singer. It's not listed here, but it's more, I think it's also more contemporary to us, but it's more folklorish, 就比较像是 folk guitar style, okay? And I don't know how they do it, but there are links below of the other ballads. Like this is our Garfunkel, but this is what he looks like, but I don't think this is his, let me see.
It fell about the Martinmas time, and a gay time it was there, though, when our good wife got buns to bake, and she got...
Right, it's not the song I included at Inside. But what is really interesting about YouTube is that so many people are doing different things at YouTube. Like, I think he is obviously teaching guitar. So he has the guitar keys here. Okay, so the chord keys. So if you are interested, maybe you can also take a look at this. And the same thing, Sir Patrick Spence has different versions, and in different stories, sometimes, like our story has it that Sir Patrick Spence dies on the way out. But there's another story that has it that Sir Patrick Spence arrives in Norway. And then he dies on the way back, and there in Norway, he I think he experienced some political conflicts or something like that. Okay, so I think that there are different versions and involving different part of the historical events. Okay, and this is this person I don't know either. This version for me is more modern, more contemporary to us. Contemporary versions are more accessible to us. So just make sure that you listen to some of them to enjoy the music and also the lines, okay? Well, in case any one of you know how to sing them, I think they'll be even better, okay? They'll be the best. Sing some of the ballads in your workstation. Sing it to your students, okay? With a guitar. Okay, I guess that'll be really effective. Okay, so let me give you the questions, and then I'll show you the different versions, and then we'll ask you how you think, how you like the different versions. Basically, in this poem, wait, let me see. Yes, in this poem, there is also the contrast between Barbara Allen and the guy. Who is either called John or William, and the others. Okay, and then also there are differences between Barbara, there's a typo here, Barbara's responses. Barbara's responses to, at different moments, for instance, the story usually starts with the news that John is about to die, and Barbara Allen is sent for. to see him for the last time. And in some versions, Barbara Allen refuses to be kind to the dying young man. She goes there very slowly, and she said that he's no good to her, etc. He's no use at all to her. Okay, in some, and then the young man responded differently in different versions. Okay, and the others response, and then after that, the young man died. And then there is the church bell, you know, suggesting the death of the young man. And the town people responded to the church bell differently. You know, some are sympathetic, and some accuses Barbara Allen of being cruel, being unworthy. Okay, and then also the ending can be different. Sometimes it just ends with Barbara Allen's death. She repent to die to death. Okay, and sometimes Barbara Allen dies for love, and at the end, on their graveyard, there are two plants. One is rose, and the other is briar. Briar 好像是荆棘，好像。And then rose and briar, they are entangled.Okay, so it's a bit like Liang San Bo Yu Zhu Ying Tai, you know, at the end, after that, they get reunited, okay, through in a different form, okay. So the story gets told differently, you know, in some versions there is a narrator, in some other versions there are no narrator, just direct telling of the story, okay. But the ballad elements are all there in different versions. For instance, simple plot, some gaps, you know, and also in beginning in the middle part, some use of really archetypal symbols, repetition, the use of rhyme and rhythm, the use of contrast. You know, these are the common elements in all the versions. So get your handout, and you get, let me see, 1, 2... Three, four. You get four versions, right? You get four versions. Okay, let me also show it online, on the screen.